So we came out of summer 2020 feeling pretty darn good about ourselves, right? We had run summer camp when most other summer camps chose not to even run. We had a great time. It was a cathartic experience. The kids felt amazing. The staff felt such a great sense of accomplishment. And we were just like, okay, let's hope that 2021 is normal and all that. But we all know the 2020 to 2021 school year was far from normal. These poor kids and teachers, did virtual learning for most of it. You had teachers that were teaching to laptops and kids. You had everybody 6 feet apart with masks on. And for the college kids, a lot of kids went off to college and spent their freshman years of college in their dorms. When the summer 2021 finally arrived, and we were so excited about it, we really didn't know what to expect. It was not like a bunch of released prisoners, as I had sort of thought it might be. The kids were pretty respectful and grateful of the situation, no doubt about it. But, you know, let's just be real. The difference between sitting in your bedroom or your kitchen staring at a laptop and being at a camp with 1,000 people, that is a huge difference. So it definitely was a summer of transition, a summer of adjustment. A summer of people being pretty psyched that we were returning to our childhoods and returning to a normal life with friends, fun, and sun, and all that good stuff. So 20th anniversary, 20 years, what are we gonna do? Well, first thing is that video you just saw, which was the brainchild of Brandy. And we had a lot of great, we have a lot of great singers on staff, some of which we didn't even ask, my apologies. But we put together a really awesome song that to me really symbolizes what we're trying to do here, right? We're trying to evoke this family feeling, this feeling of community, and I think we've done it. You know, I talk to a lot of people that have been through here as campers, counselors, and they tell me that their camp friends are their real friends. I think that's interesting because when you go to school with the same kids every day in the same town, you sort of get pigeonholed. You're the athlete kid or you're the cheerleader or whatever. You know, camp's about trying new things, trying new experiences, meeting new friends, and all that. And I think we've been pretty darn successful with that. And one of the greatest parts of our 20th anniversary is that this past summer, we had three campers whose parents were campers. Imagine that, right? We've sort of done a cycle now, okay? So there's gonna be more and more of that, which honestly is the best part of what I do, right? Seeing kids grow up and be amazing adults is really, really, that's my prize for all the hard work that we put in here. So my goal when we started this was always to be a part of the community, to be a place where people look forward to going year after year, and that, you know, little kids said, I want to be a counselor one day, and parents who came here as campers would want to send their kids to, and we've definitely accomplished that, which is super cool, and I'm super proud of. But we are certainly not finished. I mean, 20 years, I mean, look around. There's plenty we can do here. There's plenty with the infrastructure that we can do to create, you know, potentially more indoor space one day. And just, you know, we've gotten away with doing a whole lot with a whole little here. And that's honestly one of the cool parts of Liberty Lake, is that it's an outdoor back to basics kind of thing. But in the future, there's no doubt that every year we're going to still be building on what we have and create a stronger infrastructure. So imagine this, imagine we're getting ready for what's gonna be our biggest summer ever, our 20th anniversary summer. We're preparing for a year. And I get a phone call about a week before, and they're like, hey, Andy, how would you guys like to be on Good Morning America? And I was like, oh, that would be great. And I was like, when? And they're like, the first day of camp. They'll be there at 6 a.m. I'm like, what? Are you kidding me? Like, all the things I need to worry about, and now I gotta worry about Good Morning America, right? But how do you pass up such a situation? It ended up being great. You know, they interviewed parents, they interviewed kids and staff, and they got to see some real magic. Because, you know, at Liberty Lake in the Northeast, we started camp about a week before most other camps did. So once again, we were the canary in the coal mine. So it's nice to be seen by all the other camps in the country as leaders in what we're doing. We're off and running week one. So, you know, the second day of camp, ugly shorts day. So that was something that one of my friends was doing at his camp. And I took his idea. I'm gonna admit right now, Jonathan from Oak Crest, I took your idea. So, and part of it was we had to figure out a way that the camp director would win every year so that we could burn his shorts on the flagpole, right? So that's where that sort of came from. App Attack was something that we had done, I don't know, like 10 years ago when apps first became a thing. Brandy helped come up with that. But Yacht or Not, I mean, that's a 20-year staple. But I do have to say that the big switch in Yacht or Not came probably about 8 years ago, when we shifted it from the pool to the lake. That's right, all you kids. Yacht or Not used to be done at the pool. And it was more dangerous, actually, because what happened was, you have to imagine, all the boxes were at the edge of the pool, like on the side of the pool. And then I would say, on your marks, get set, go, right? And then they would push the boxes off the side of the pool, and then most of them would just go right into the water. I gotta give a shout out. I think it was Ryder, girls, that won. Man, these junior girls. We haven't had a non-senior or teens group win Yacht or Not, I don't know, since I can remember, maybe ever. But this junior girls group, they came together like team. I mean, that was teamwork in its ultimate, it really was. And it makes me feel good when the group leader, Nicole Comley, is a former little cute camper who now is an awesome, great leader. And she just pulled her kids together great, and her co-counselor, and the rest of the crew. It was really phenomenal. And then, you know, Jersey Day, typical great Liberty Lake thing, you know, except now we have Gritty. Who will ever forget the giant leprechaun? All he had to do was put on a Flyers outfit and he looked just like Gritty. That's right, Connor. One of the things I want to say about week two is we had the watermelon seed spin contest. And if you read closely on here, it says, and chickpeas. So let me explain that fully. So when we were starting off in the early 2000s and we didn't have two nickels to rub together and we had to come up with cheap, you know, spirit events and things, you know, there's really nothing more campy than a watermelon seed spitting contest. So that was a staple and we did it every single year. And I remember one year we had trouble and we had to getting the watermelons and we had to resort to chickpeas, which is why that made it in there. But the funny thing about this contest is that for this year, we called our food vendors that we get our watermelons from, because watermelon is a staple here at Liberty Lake. We have watermelon a lot of lunches, okay, and at our picnics. We go through watermelons like you wouldn't believe. But they're seedless, right? And I figured we were ordering seedless watermelons, but actually, they only make seedless watermelons. Like, at some point in the last 20 years since we've been around, scientists have changed the genetics of watermelon, removing the seeds from it, except for who knows where. So we could not get watermelons with seeds. So what do? You go into Google and you type watermelon seeds, and it pops up on Amazon, and it turns out that you can buy dried watermelon seeds. They're sort of like corn nuts, right? Dried watermelon seeds, they're salted, and they taste pretty good. I mean, they're sort of like pumpkin seeds, right? You all like pumpkin seeds, right? They're salty, they're good, right? So those were our watermelon seeds for 2021. And you know, at Liberty Lake, we do the best we can do with whatever we can get. Let's talk about Wet n Wild and Paint n Wild. Never before had we tried to do both in a year, but it's our 20th anniversary. So why not just throw it all in there with the kitchen sink, right? So these two have been longtime staples. Wet n Wild we've done almost every year, and Paint n Wild started, I don't know, maybe 10 years ago we started doing. And what we had done, what Brandy had suggested, is that we alternated years, right? This year we did them both. And I mean, they loved it, right? You know, we get stuff for the pools, we get stuff for the blacktop. You know, the kids, it's really helpful when it's a really hot day, certainly. And you know, 2021, hottest summer of all time. So that worked out. And then Paint n Wild, yeah, that's messy. And we get lots of different colored paints, and kids are allowed to paint each other and splatter it and throw it and this and that and the other thing with paint. You know, camp, let me get philosophical for a moment. Camp should be about things that you don't normally do at home. And I tend to think, as cool as you may think you are as a parent, yeah, probably don't let the kids open up a bucket of paint and just start splattering all over the place. So, at Liberty Lake, again, we're all outdoors, right? So, I mean, it's certainly helpful that, you know, it's not splattering on the walls, but we do it. And I do warn the parents. We tell them, you know, when you pick your child up today, make sure you have a towel for your car and all that kind of thing, because the kids leave that day looking extraterrestrial. Week four, I mean, starts out with a lookalike contest. I mean, the lookalike contest, another original 20-year thing that we've been doing. I gotta credit my friends at Black Bear Lake. That's where we got that one from. And it works great. You know, you find a kid in camp, or a counselor, or an animal, I guess, that looks like you. You get your picture taken, everybody votes on it. Super fun, super cute, super easy. And you know, when we were starting off in 2002, the most important thing, super cheap. it's awesome. And there are kids that come off the bus on the first day of camp, and they get immediately grabbed and say, "Oh my God, you look exactly like Adriana. We're gonna make sure we take a picture of you with her, and you're gonna definitely win." But they never definitely win. I don't know. To me, the people that win every single year are not the people that you would consider the favorites. But it was all legit. I want to go on record, as I do all the time on these videos, and say, at Liberty Lake, when we vote things, and that's even Color War finals, everything is 100% legit, okay? We do not change scores. Everything is as it laid out. So I don't think there's ever been a lookalike contest winner that was somebody that I had thought would win. It's always a surprise, right? Which is what Color War generally is too. Let's talk Gaga. 20 years of Gaga at Liberty Lake. We started with one court this past summer. We might have had seven for a while until the flood came and took one away. But Gaga is the ultimate sport of Liberty Lake. It combines all the star points into one giant hexagon where kids have to respect each other. They can be competitive, but there has to be a level of integrity that happens. And it's an individual sport, but yet you're all together. So there's teamwork involved. And people are looking at each other. So friendship comes through too. You know, this was one of those places where we had to forge forward even during COVID. You know, we did individual groups at a time, which of course they didn't have to be masked. But then we masked the kids to do the divisional finals and then the actual championship finale that took place right down there at the Gaga pit that doesn't exist at this moment. We have to rebuild on the lower field. I don't know how many of you remember. It was a really hot day of the Gaga tournament. Like, it was 100 degree hot, sweltering day. And we were like, yeah, you gotta wear your masks, you know, to do this if you're gonna compete, you know, against other kids in other groups. And the kids absolutely did it. And you know, congratulations to my man Drew Oswalt, who came through at the end. Young guy, right? Not a senior, right? Not a CIT, okay? And Drew, you got like, you know, 4 or 5 years now, you could possibly be a repeat champion, so people are gonna be gunning for you. So be careful out there. All right, Tug-o-War. So when we started Tug-o-War back in 2002, I can pretty much remember, who knows, but I can pretty much remember it being chocolate pudding for a while. And then we had a staff person, I think it was Kelly Huminski, that actually came back last year and worked with us, who was allergic to chocolate, and we did vanilla for her for a year. And then I sent my kids to sleepaway camp, and at their sleepaway camp, they did Jell-O wrestling. And I said, how do you make mass Jell-O? And they told me how. And we took that idea, and basically, we're creating Jell-O in giant drums. And let me tell you, folks, Jell-O without sugar is pretty gross. I hate to tell you that, okay? Jell-O needs sugar, and it needs lots of it. So we stuck with Jell-O for a while, then we would go back to chocolate. And then there was a year that it had rained really bad, liquid sunshine, really badly the prior day, and it was really muddy. And Brandy had a suggestion that we should basically dig a big hole out on that field over there, and let's do mud tug of war. And it was awesome. But we went back to the old standard of Jell-O this year. And it was gross and it was a lot of fun. And I have to say that the boys did beat the girls more than usual, which is not normal. Trust me, the girls win plenty. So yeah, Jell-O Tug-o-War. Also, during week 5 was the Haunted Trail.
No, scary! Ah! Bah! 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 Yeah. No,
I'm out of here, people!
Yeah, we know!
Shout out to Spirit Bob and Eileen and Jenny and the Team Taco crew that that put that thing together. And I don't know if we have actual video footage, but I know we have some very scary pictures of Spirit Bob emerging from the spaceship in his alien outfit. Shocking, let's just say. And the kids took it in stride, you know, and he only got beat up a couple times by those kids because, you know, it's a space alien. You're allowed to beat up space aliens. I mean, if a space alien pops up, you know, he's a space alien, right? You know, you don't know. We're gonna assume they're hostile. So, week 6, Tug-o-War returns. Man, I cannot thank the generals of the Tug-o-War teams enough. These dedicated staff people came in weeks before, practicing their cheers, being creative, coming up with themes, coming up with songs, decorating the stages, decorating the tents in the amphitheater, really just to make the kids happy. Right, yeah, they want to win too, I know. But also, they're doing it for the kids. I mean, there really is no more selfless job in this camp than to be a Tug-o-War general. Came down to the wire, as it always does. And I know I say that. I know it must sound like Andy always says that. That can't be true, but I swear it's true, okay? The teams are generally evenly matched, okay? Now, I know when we did boys against girls, that wasn't fair, okay? But generally speaking, they're evenly matched. And it does come down to the sing at the end. And the thing like last year is that all the teams had good songs. Right? So then it just, you know, it really comes down to the judges. What do they like? What kind of songs they like? And who performs best, right? Because there's some teams that have really great songs and they do them great during rehearsals. And then they do them a little bit less than great during the sing because there's a lot of pressure and they're nervous. It's a new situation and all that, and a new place and all that kind of thing. But I was really proud of everybody. And I mean that sincerely. And I wished all three teams could have won this year because they were phenomenal. Right? And was it the red team that won? red team had won, edged out the tie dyes and the blue team. And you know, usually we do. We used to. That's 20 year story. So when we started, this is what we did. We would figure out who won, and we would have a gator race. So back in the day, there was only two teams, okay? And we'd have a red team and a blue team, and they were, we would decorate the gators, right? The golf cart gator things. And they would go on a predetermined route, and there'd be some comedy would ensue, okay? And then, you know, we would let them know which one should win. I think one of the last years we did the gator race was when we did Boys Against Girls the first time. And my wife drove the girls' gator, dressed as the Statue of Liberty, by the way, okay? It's in the gator, and we're supposed to go around this tree and make it, right? So I go around the tree, she goes into the tree, okay? And then I had to act like I was crazy or something so that they would pass me and win, and then they won. To which everybody was like, wow, okay? And that's how it was all about the gator race. And then the kids all thought, oh, the gator lost, it's their fault. And now it made it a lot better, I guess. I think after that, we switched to having somebody come over to zip line. Yeah, well, we built a zip line at that point. That was new. That wasn't 20 years. That was probably 10 years. So we built a zip line, and then the person, the winning team would come over the return zip line. But last year, because we had to find a pandemic safe location to do the Color Wars thing, and it ended up being the Willows Field, which worked out nicely, they couldn't see the zip line area. So we had to come up with a solution. So, Brandy, literally on that day, okay, on the day of the finals, we came up with an idea to put one person from each team into one of those like giant, almost like sumo circle things. Like they, and by the way, we had a red one. No, we had a blue one, and we had one that could sort of be, I don't know. We had to paint them, is what it comes down to. And God, I still had the picture of Jen Polios. Looked hilarious in my head. But and Mickey, who was the third person? Let's go to the videotape. They did their big wrestling act, and we knew who won. And the winner was anointed, and it worked out so fabulously. So I'm gonna DLP you right now, Brandon. Great job coming up with a solution to how to determine the finals winner of Color War. That showed tremendous creativity. High five. Week 8. I'm pretty sure that was the plug week, you know. Can't remember everything from the summer right away. Certainly wasn't on the spirit calendar. So on that day, well, let's go back to that night. The night before, it rained all night, okay? Really bad. Justin and I, my son, we came into camp that morning at 5:30 in the morning, and it was stopping raining, and there was a little bit of flooding on the back of our lower field, which is normal. That's a place, that's the low point of camp, and that's where it would flood. Well, turns out that it rained a lot elsewhere. And all that elsewhere water came into the tributaries that lead into the creek. And even though everything was totally fine at 8 in the morning, by the time we got to 9 in the morning, when all the kids got here, basically anywhere over there that was grass was water. And it was very interesting. For sure. And a great opportunity for everybody to band together and figure out what to do. Because by the way, that kind of thing happens at sleepaway camps all the time. Doesn't normally happen at day camps though, okay? So what the heck did we do? Well, my counselors and group leaders, I love you. Thank you so much for working so hard that day. Harder than ever. I know it, I appreciate it. And it paid off. The kids, everybody ate, it was a little bit different, everybody adapted, everybody's like, oh my God, I can't believe it, kind of attitude, but we persevered through. And to me, what a great lesson for the kids about resiliency. And I think it was about 1 in the afternoon that it started receding, right? So that by the time the next day came, it was just very muddy down here, which did impact Campapalooza, which we did not have in its normal state this year. It will be back in full force in 2022. Campapalooza started way back when as a, we employed a concert tour called Camplified that came for 3 years, and they brought recording artists and stages and such with us, with them. And the kids got to get autographs and all kinds of fun stuff. But we were like, and I say we, I mean Brandy, was like, we can do this on our own. And I think she sort of always envisioned a sort of Woodstock thing. She has told me numerous times that we named it Campstock in hindsight. And certainly having the new stage now on the lower field, which tends to get muddy, we will always have that Woodstock kind of vibe. Perseverance, grit, resiliency. I mean, when you're at a camp that's outdoors on 60 acres, as I always say, Mother Nature always wins, right? And it's how we adapt, it's how we dress, it's how our attitudes are to forge forward and be able to make it through. And then feel the sense of accomplishment afterwards. I want to talk to you now about the giant slide. We've had a few giant slides here at Liberty Lake. We do have the Zoom Plume, which is a giant slide in many ways. But you know, I'm partners at a camp up in Massachusetts called Everwood, and I visited them a few years ago, and they had created a giant slide into their lake, which I thought was super cool, and I was like, we have to figure out how to do that. So we did, and seeing these kids slide their behinds into this mud pit, you know, of water, wow. They would go a division at a time, and there would be staff that were volunteering to stand in the water at the bottom of the hill, in the water mud pit, that were making sure that when the kids landed, they landed safely and they got out safely. So kudos to you all. Summer 2021, our 20th anniversary summer. We will remember you always. It was crazy. It was hard. It was fun. It was all worthwhile. It was the kind of summer that you'll never forget because of the emotions that were involved. After a year and a half of staring at screens, mostly in our homes, we were given the freedom. We were given a ticket to freedom. Thank you, parents, for having faith in us and trust in us. Thank you, staff, for having faith in us and trust in us. Thank you to my staff's parents for letting them come and be awesome role models and shepherding awesome character values and life skills to these kids. With all the heat and, you know, worrying about COVID and all that kind of stuff, floods, it was all worthwhile in the end. And we all felt like it gave us a jump start in getting back to school and our regular lives and the way things used to be. And I know things aren't back to normal just yet, but they're on their way. And for those of us who were at camp in 2021, I feel like we had we're better prepared for that. We had a taste of it. We were allowed to run around and smile, take our masks off if we wanted to, just feel the joy and the energy of being around a lot of happy people. It's an honor to have been a part of it. That's how I look at it. And I and the rest of y'all, I know for sure, are looking forward to summer 2022, where hopefully we can really get back to normal, get back to electives the way we used to do them, and spirit events the way we used to do them, and really be able to put our creativity to work. And just keep it rolling here, right? This will be our 21st summer next year, and we're on our way to our, you know, quarter century mark. We'll see you all right? I hear it's gonna be a snowy, cold winter. Okay, so you know what that means. Think about camp. Think about those days when you had to walk up that hill to get to the Twin Cedars on a 100 degree day. You're like, oh, my gosh, Andy, can't you put an escalator in here, please? Right? Because, yeah. Summer's coming, right? It's less than 200 days. It's right around the corner. Before you know it, right? The flowers will be blooming and the birds will be chirping again, right? And the countdown will be on for another awesome summer. Take care, everybody. Happy holidays. Love you guys. So going back to 20, I got lots of 20th anniversary stories. So, so yeah, we had a flood this year. Woohoo, it was a flood, okay? But did you also know that we had an earthquake at Liberty Lake, right? I don't know, those of you who are older that remember back like 10 years ago, there was an earthquake in Northern Burlington County. And it was happening during post week at Liberty Lake. And I remember, walking out of the office, and everybody was just like doing this, right? And people were like, you feeling this, you know, that kind of thing, you know? And people in the office ran outside because the office was shaking too. Yeah, and we had a legit earthquake. So with earthquake, we had flood. And then I think like, I don't know, was it 5, 6, 7 years ago? We had an eclipse. We had a freaking lunar eclipse, right? Where everybody was like, don't look at the sun. It'll burn your eyes out. Oh my God, what are you gonna do? Andy, what are you gonna do to keep the kids from burning their eyes out? You know, an eclipse, like, I don't know, right? Send them with sunglasses, I don't know. But we actually had some people that had those special glasses, and then we were doing the thing, we were like over our shoulder, on paper, we were doing all that kind of stuff. So, all right, eclipse, floods, earthquake, tropical storms, okay, yeah, we closed camp twice in 2020. So yeah, what am I missing?
Volcano?
Well, who knows what's under here? I mean, you never know. You never know. You know, I've only been here 21 years now, so you never know.
The place to be.
Liberty Lake is the place to be.
Feeling really good about being me. Liberty Lake is number one.
Liberty Lake is number one.
Counselors and kids having so much fun.
Counselors and kids having so much
fun. Liberty Lake.
Liberty Lake.
Liberty Lake.
Liberty Lake.
swimming pool. Golfing in Gaga, we love to play. Lots of cool electives every day. Every single day. Liberty family knows how to play. Smiling and laughing and making new friends.
Been here since I was a baby. I apologize for all the times I drove you. fucking rats with disrespect, or that name is